New York City, like much of the country, is experiencing an opioid overdose crisis. In fact, someone dies of a drug overdose every 7 hours in New York City. And in 2017, over 1,400 people died of a drug overdose. Opioids were involved in the majority of those deaths. So, what are opioids? Opioids are pain relievers and include prescription painkillers such as OxyContin, Vicodin, or Percocet, as well as drugs like heroin. Fentanyl is a fast-acting opioid that's 50 to 100 times stronger than morphine and is leading to an increase in overdose deaths. Heroin, cocaine, counterfeit street pills marked as Xanax, and other drugs may contain fentanyl, which can't be detected by sight, taste, or smell. It's important to remember that use of any opioid may cause side effects such as slow or stopped breathing and can lead to an overdose. But how do you know if someone may be experiencing an opioid overdose? Overdose happens when someone takes more or stronger opioids than their body can manage, leading to respiratory depression or a suppressed urge to breathe. Some possible signs of an overdose include being unconscious or passed out, slower or stopped breathing, lips or fingernails turning blue or gray, depending on skin tone, making snoring or gurgling sounds, and in cases of fentanyl overdose, we've also heard of cases where people become extremely rigid or stiff. While it's rare for someone to die immediately from an overdose, it is important to respond quickly. When people survive, it's usually because someone was there to respond. Keep in mind, someone who isn't overdosing may be drowsy or sedated, but they will respond to an external stimuli like a loud noise or a shake. So, what can you do if you're worried someone might be overdosing? First, check for responsiveness. The easiest way is to do a shake, shout, and rub. First, shake the individual as if you're trying to wake them from a deep sleep.
Then shout, "Hey, can you hear me?"
If the person does not respond to being shaken or shouted at, then do a sternal rub. Make a fist and rub it, applying some pressure on the person's sternum or breastbone for about 5 to 10 seconds. If the person responds, monitor them and keep naloxone ready. The person should not be left alone. If they don't respond, it's an emergency. The first thing you should do if someone doesn't respond to the sternal rub is call 911. It's important to have backup on the way. There can be complications, or the person might be having a different kind of medical emergency. With some exceptions, the 911 Good Samaritan Law provides protection to someone overdosing or someone calling 911 to save a life, even if drugs are present. Next, give naloxone if you have it. Naloxone is available as a nasal spray or an injection. In this video, we'll provide instruction for the single-step Narcan nasal spray. Narcan comes in a blister pack like this. Peel the package to remove the device. Put the nozzle in either nostril until your fingers touch the bottom of the person's nose. Press the plunger firmly to release the dose into the person's nose. It's important not to test the device or press the plunger until the nozzle is in the person's nose. All the medication is dispensed once the plunger is pushed. Narcan can take 2 to 8 minutes to work, and sometimes more than one dose of naloxone is needed. If the person has not become responsive after 2 minutes, give a second dose. If you can, try using the other nostril this time. If you don't remember which one you used, don't worry, just give the second dose. Hopefully, after giving 1 or 2 doses of naloxone, the person will become responsive. If this happens, first, tell them what happened. They may be confused. Explain that they were overdosing and you gave them Narcan. If the person takes opioids regularly, they might experience withdrawal symptoms until the naloxone wears off. It's important to explain that naloxone lasts between 30 to 90 minutes and that using more drugs is unlikely to reduce withdrawal but it could increase the risk for another overdose. Medical attention is important. Encourage the person to wait for the ambulance. The person who overdosed shouldn't be left alone for at least 3 hours, since another overdose is possible when the naloxone wears off. If a person doesn't become responsive right away, it's important to know about the recovery position. Place the person's arm or hand under their head. Tilt their head back slightly to open an airway. Bend the arm and leg that's furthest from the ground to prevent them from rolling on their stomach. In addition to calling for help and giving naloxone, you can also do CPR if you know how, or simply provide rescue breaths. Getting oxygen to an overdosing person might reduce serious complications and can keep a person alive until help arrives. In your kit, you will find a rescue breathing mask that can act as a shield between you and the other person. Place the person on their back, tilt their head back, and open their mouth. Place the face mask over their nose and mouth to create a barrier. Pinch the person's nose closed and give 2 regular breaths into the mouth. Continue with 1 breath every 5 seconds. Ensure that their chest is rising and not their stomach. Readjust if necessary. Let's wrap up by reviewing what you can do if you think someone might be overdosing. First, check for responsiveness. Shake, shout, and rub. If they don't respond, call 911. Backup is critical, especially in light of fentanyl in the drug supply. Next, give Narcan. Remember the simple steps: peel, place, and press. Don't forget you have a second dose in case the person doesn't respond within 2 minutes. If the person wakes up, it's important to explain what happened and encourage them to go with the ambulance. It's important that they're not alone for at least 3 hours in case of another overdose. And don't forget the recovery position and rescue breathing are important tools in emergency response. You can review all of the information provided in this video, plus learn about overdose prevention and find naloxone near you, or submit an anonymous report if you use your naloxone by downloading the Stop OD NYC app, available in both the iPhone and Android app stores. By following the response steps outlined in this video, you can save a life.